In this module overview, we will look at the cash management module. Cash management needs to be set up before you can work in AP and AR, because this is where you'd set up your banks. You have your checking accounts, credit card accounts, and savings accounts. This is also where you do your bank reconciliation, and you can do reconciliation against your credit card if you're using your credit card as if it was a type of bank, as in opposed to just paying off your credit card each month through AP. You actually want to track all the transactional charges on a credit card. This allows you to do the reconciliation. In here is also where you'd create your ACH files and download them for import into your bank. You can also create bank files, which are bank wires, and create then download the files and import them. Intacct does not create the ACH payments themselves. You'd have to pull the file and send it to your bank. Also, because of Intacct's bank feed function, you're able to pull down the transactions from your particular banks, and you can view them here. Of course, I have none because I don't have a bank set up in demo. This is where you look at them, and this is also where you can ignore or unignore certain transactions that aren't relevant to your current bank reconciliation. More on that later. It's also where you could do a manual deposit. So if you have undeposited funds, if you use the undeposited funds account, you create your deposits here or in AR. You can also do funds transfer. What this does is it allows you to transfer funds between banks. You would set up, you put your bank one account here and a bank account here and transfer the funds. Now understand, these transfers are just in Intacct. It's not physically done at your bank. You'd still have to do that. But this moves it from one cash account to another. It's also where you set up your interest and charges entries, you know, bank fees, interest that you might receive from the bank for your account, things like that. You could also do a manual payment. This is where you do a one-off AP bill, basically. The same function is available in AP, as you'll see when we review that module. And it allows you to do, say, someone comes in and repair something for you, and you write them a check right then, they hand you an invoice. Well, you may not send that through your AP, normal AP process. This allows you to create the bill and pay it all at once. Other receipts is a way to receive money that isn't normally run through accounts receivable. So say someone comes in, this really applies to more like charities or nonprofits where someone may walk in off the street, give you a $100 donation, and you need to create a receipt for them. This allows you to create the invoice and receive the money all at once. In the credit card section, this is where you enter your credit card transactions. If you're going to use the credit cards as a type of bank where you need to track each individual transaction and reconcile them, this is where you put your administrative fees and charges from the card. And this is where you make your charge payoffs to pay off these transactions. This will create an AP bill that you can track in your AP. You also have your subledger where you can open and close it individually of the GL. You can print payment copies. You have your standard operational reports, cash analysis, balances, and your registers, bank check, credit card deposit receipts. Over here, you have your accounts again. This was originally where they were until Intacct was nice and put them all on one screen. So you can create your checking or credit or savings accounts. Intacct also has what are called reconciliation rules. This is a new function, relatively. What it does is it allows you to set up a certain set of rules and put them as a set and assign them to the banks. So when you go to do your bank reconciliation and you're pulling in your bank transactions and your Intacct transactions, the rule set will do an auto match to match whatever it can based on the rule parameters that you set. This is a big time saver. It also allows you to review those matches in case something's wrong or you don't want to, you say that's not right. So it's not like once they're set, you can't change it. You are able to review the matches and fix them if you need to. You also have reconciliation transaction templates, and all this we'll go over when we do the bank reconciliation modules, learning modules, that is. And this is also where you set up your ACH bank configuration for your banks. This is going to set up the ACH configurations that your banks would use, not your vendors. And this is what allows you to create the proper ACH files to import into your banks. And with that, we will move on to the next module.